Our life can't be a simmering broth where true and false co-jointly live, but there must be a purer path from which we, soul's estate, can view. The self-awareness of the soul, to know her own divinity, denotes the purpose and the goal of human life, as it should be.
Ambition, passion, lust, desire, each impulse, urge, or appetite which move, propel, or set on fire, or fill with pain, grief, or delight the mind, must be judiciously brought under the control of man to help him climb courageously the height prescribed in nature's plan.
Knowledge, entirely in the dark, about this crown of human life, must soon a new course embark to clear the erroneous notions rife. Hence this inspired direction came to guide humanity aright, as dogma has made knowledge lame, bias and hubris weak in sight. So he cannot discern the path which nature for man has aligned. His cooks too many spoil the broth, more so when some are lame, some blind. That is why revelations come to set the wrongs of knowledge right, to muffle his loud beating drum and bring his faults and fibs to light.
This magic show none can explain. This mystery no one can solve. Only when we remold our brain this giant phantom can dissolve, to leave one breathless, face to face, with that from which we draw our thought, beyond the pale of time and space by which this phantom world is wrought.
It is not the method, but the heart, which does the Lord of all enshrine. Self-worship from it must depart, before the light of lights can shine. How can we hide our faults from one who sees each flutter of our heart? Can we hide from the blazing sun the faintest cloud with all our art? No store of learning, wit, or skill can help to make us pure of heart, unless we pray and use our will to keep ourselves from using art.
Be calm and cool with manners mild. Avoid excesses and extremes. The artless nature of a child will bring fulfillment to your dreams. Study the scriptures of great creeds and cull the teachings they impart. Soon you will find that noble deeds with love and purity of heart, expressed in simple word and phrase, are all essentials of the root that can embodied spirit raise to glimpses of the absolute.
It is because they do not know the arduous nature of the quest that false adepts their promptness show to guide raw seekers to the crest. That is why from the learned too, some are now keen to join the game, contending why they should not woo this nymph of easy wealth and fame. There is no chance they will succeed, and their design to steal the show, for time will soon expose their greed and infamy heap on their brow.
The urge in us to soar above the world to see what lies behind is nature's artifice to endow the species with a supermind. The trouble is, we are too prone to be enamored of our faults, and on this plea or that condone their presence which our progress halts. It is imperative on those who to a supermind aspire that they the vent holes tightly close to bar wrong motive and desire.
It is not as hard as is said to discipline the human mind, since we have nature's law misread, that we the task so heavy find. As our upliftment to the plane of superknowledge is in line with nature's aim to upgrade the brain, it must self-mastery combine.
Were there no fault or blemish left for us to exert our skill and brain, how could we grow more smart and deft, or more extended knowledge gain?
If you find self-reform too hard in spite of your intense desire, for lack of firmness to discard the habits that stink of the mire, there is no reason to despair. Try what you can time and again. Beseech your maker to repair the faults in human strength.